A C++ program is basically a collection of statements and expressions, usually organized into functions and classes. In this lesson, I'll show you the general anatomy of a C++ program. Please understand that this is not exhaustive. There are many other elements that may be involved in a C++ program. This is just the basics. It's just important that you have a general overview of how these things work. Here's a sample Hello World in C++. Whitespace is any characters that are normally invisible, including new lines, spaces and tabs. And whitespace is mostly ignored in C++. One notable exception is when a space is necessary to distinguish between two words or tokens. For example, the space between the words int and main is significant and is required. Extra spaces would be ignored. Comments are notations in the code that are ignored by the compiler. In practice, they are stripped out by the preprocessor. C++ supports two different types of comments. Single-line comments are introduced by two forward slashes. The comment ends at the end of the line. In this example, there are two separate comments, each on a line by itself. A comment may begin on a line after existing code without affecting the code itself. C++ also supports multi-line comments. A multi-line comment may span several lines. The comment begins at the special slash asterisk token, and it ends after the matching asterisk slash token. Both styles of comments are inherited from the C language. The multi-line comment was part of the original C language, and the single-line comment was added later. The entry point for any C++ program is always a function called main. All C++ programs must have a main function. This is also true for C. The main function may also have arguments for parsing the command line. The first argument is an integer representing the number of command line arguments. The second argument is an array of character arrays. The second argument is sometimes written like this. It means exactly the same thing. We'll cover arrays and pointers in more detail later in this course. The body of a function is enclosed in curly braces. The code between the braces is run whenever the function is called. The main function must return an integer value. 0 is commonly returned to indicate the program exited normally. To indicate an error condition, a main function would return a 1 instead of a 0. Other values may have other meanings in specific circumstances. The include directive instructs the preprocessor to include another file to pass to the compiler. In this case, we're including the C standard IO header, which supports the puts function as well as other standard functions that C++ inherits from C. It is very common to include header files at the top of your source code. In fact, it is rare for a program not to include header files. One final note. You'll often see this line done in other ways. This is also valid. I choose to use puts instead of cout because it's simple. So let's take a look at this in the IDE. You notice I have comments at the top, I have the include directive, and I have the main function with its contents inside curly braces. And when I build and run this, it displays the message, "Hello World." So as we learned, whitespace is entirely ignored. So I can eliminate a lot of this whitespace, right? I can even eliminate that, and save and build and run. And you notice that it works exactly the same. I can put all this whitespace back. I can add a bunch of extra new lines. I can put extra spaces in. If I put extra spaces here inside the quotes, you'll notice that it'll actually display those extra spaces. Those are not ignored because they're inside the quotes. But everything else here is entirely ignored. I can put in comments. I can use multi-line comments. Or I can put in single-line comments like here. And when I build and run, it works exactly the same.